Very good morning. Today we'll discuss the concept of transport layer. What is a transport layer? What are the services it provides? The ultimate goal is to provide efficient, reliable, and cost-effective services to the users here. And it make use of services of network layer and normally process in the application layer. The transport layer is within a hardware software within a transport layer does work with called as a transport entity here, located in operating system kernel in separate user process in a library package bounded in a network application. There are two types of transport services. One is connection oriented transport service, one is a connectionless transport service here. Transport code runs on user machines. Network layer works on the routers operated by the carrier. Bottom layers as a transport service provider. Upper layers as a transport service user here. So when you see this diagram, there are two different hosts which are transferring data between these two hosts here. Two end hosts, you can say. And these two end hosts have all the five layers of TCP/IP protocol stack, starting from the application layer where you are running the certain kind of applications like browser. And you can have the transport layer which provides the end-to-end connectivity between the two hosts here and help you to find out a suitable path between the two devices here in the network here through multiple intermediate devices like a routers, switches. After the network layer, you have the data link layer. The task of data link layer is to provide channel access mechanisms here. When multiple nodes are trying to transmit simultaneously and they are utilizing the same communication media like same wireless channel or same wide network. And physical layer finally of protocol stack which take care of the physical layer signaling techniques and different modulation and coding schemes here. Now the two ends in the diagram, they have the both five layers of protocol stack from application layer to the physical layer. Application layer, transport layer, network layer and data link layer and the physical layer. Now the intermediate device, they may not have these all five different layers. And so for example, in network, you have two devices which we call as a layer 2 switch. For example, switch or a layer 2 switch. The layer 2 switch has a protocol stack up to the second layer. Then you can have the layer 3 switch, layer 3 device, can call as a router or layer 3 device or layer 3 switch. The layer 2 switch, this is a layer 2, layer 3 switch here. So this layer 3 switch or a router, they have up to the network layer of a protocol stack here. So they help in finding out the paths among the multiple hosts or multiple devices in the network when you are trying to make an end-to-end communication. Now this transport layer, it sits on top of the network layer, and transport layer is only there's only end-to-end host, and task of transport layer is to ensure end-to-end performance or end-to-end functionalities of the network here. So we will look into the detail that what are the different end-to-end functionalities here in the network which can be utilized for are which we can be implemented as a part of the transport. The transport layer to make two end devices communicate with each other or talk with each other called as a socket programming to find how to send the data end to end between the two devices here. So before going to that, let us look into various aspects of our various design primitives of a transport layer, which is being utilized by the network to ensure reliable and high performance data delivery between the any two hosts in the network or to any remote host in the network. So if there are two remote hosts can be sitting in two different countries or two parts of the world. So it may be happen that one machine may residing say in our MVSI college and one machine may residing in other place in other country in Google office. So when they are trying to make these two nodes talk to each other, it is just like a you need to have the setup multiple end-to-end functionalities here. Like the lower layer of protocol stack, first of all, they are not reliable, can be packet loss from the lower end of the protocol stack. So transport layer ensures the reliability of the data transmission here. At the same time, it also offers multiple other services. So let us look into details here of how these different services are implemented in the transport layer of the protocol stack here. Coming to the protocol stack implementation in the host, we have five layers according to TCP/IP. The implementation of this protocol stack nothing but a semantics of your different layers of a protocol stack. If you look into the individual end host, individual computer, a computer per primarily have three different models, like a bottom, you have the hardware model, the bottom of the layers can have the hardware model of a computer. In the case of networking devices, the hardware model contains NIC card here, network interface card. NIC we can call as a network interface card here. So this network interface card provides you hardware layer functionalities here. So the entire physical layer is implemented is a part of hardware, is a part of the network interface card here. Then top of the hardware you can have the firmware or device driver. So the firmware or device driver, it provides a way to interact with the physical layer here. So the firmware or device driver that has been implemented as a part of data link layer and the part of the physical layer. Firmware as well as the device driver is a part of data link layer as well as the physical layer, part of the physical layer here. It varies from different variant of network and different variant of vendors here. Say for example, if you think about the wireless network, so physical layer is entirely implemented in the hardware, and also nowadays some part of wireless data link layer protocol does implement the part of the hardware here. So to make it fast or to make it more robust in the context of large amount of data delivery, and other hand, many of device drivers in wireless environment as well as in a wide environment, you can say. The data link layer is implemented as a part of device driver or a firmware, you can say. So the device driver or firmware that you install on for your network interface card here. The primarily have the MAC layer implementation. Then the part of MAC layer, which is a later we will see, is a logical connection. So part of the MAC layer and the upper part of the protocol stack like a network. So part of the MAC layer and then the router as part of the stack like a network layer, and transport layer implementation, they are implemented as a part of the software at the kernel of your network protocol stack here. So it is a part of the kernel. If you think about the Unix type of operating system, where inside the kernel you have the implementation of higher part of the data of the network layer, sometimes we can call as a IP layer in the context of TCP protocol stack here, and implementation of transport layer. The different type of transport layer protocols which are implemented as a part of your software are part of your operating system or Unix environment here. Then at top of your, you have multiple applications running here. Then top of you have multiple applications running here. So these different applications are designed by the different network designer, different application designers. We'll also learn how to implement a network application, which we can talk over the two end devices here. So this application can be a browser application to access a web data, or application can be a certain kind of chat application where multiple parties want to chat with each other here, or it can something like standalone applications here. For example, in an Android based operation system, you see there are multiple applications. Example, you can take Facebook application, Twitter application, YouTube application that can access data over all different applications can be implemented as a part of your application layer here. Now in the below application, we have the transport layer of protocol stacks. So you can think of this transport layer, it makes the interface between your the user interface, user application and operating system here. So whenever the data from the user application is going to the operating system, it goes via transport layer here. So let us look into the how these different layers of protocol stack adds up there over a view of about how data is being passed through multiple layers of a protocol stack here. This slide explains how application data passes through the different layers here. So in application layer, if you think about the context of an HTTP application, HTTP stands for Hypertext Transfer Protocol, is a one part of a communication protocol of the application layer, which is sending the data on top of the browser. So you have a HTTP data that is coming from the browser, and on top of that HTTP protocol, it is adds up to your own header here. So HTTP header information, it contains various information about the application layer connectivity. Then the entire data, the HTTP data along with this HTTP header, that comes as a part of your transport layer data. So you can see this diagram. So this protocol layer data is entire data which is coming from the application layer, with this transport layer data adapt to the transport layer header here. So we look into the different types of transport layer protocols like TCP protocol, UDP protocol, and various other transport layers protocols are like RTP, real transport protocol. So very individual protocol which you are going to use is this. So as a application developer here, you have to mention that which particular transport layer protocol you are going to utilize, you are going to use for the purpose, whether you are going to use the TCP type or application type, or whether you are going to use the UDP type of application. So the difference between the TCP types or application and the UDP type of applications we'll look into shortly. So the transport layer has its own header with transport layer data and contains multiple information for mapping the transport layer protocol. Now this entire transport layer data and transport layer header, it comes as a data to the network layer here, and network layer adds upon its own header. It comes to the data link layer, again adds its own data header. When it comes to the MAC header in the context of data link layer, finally it becomes a physical layer into the physical layer of data which is coming from the HTTP. Then different types of headers which have been added to the different layers of the protocol stack here. So application layer, it has add up to HTTP header, then transport layer add up to the its own header, then IP header, then the MAC header, finally data link layer has to add the its own header, and the physical layer adds the up to the physical header, and sometime for some protocol it also adds up to the trial layer, physical trailer layer, actually to identify end-to-end frame in the network, so that the entire thing gets delivered over the network here. That is physical header, MAC header, IP header, TCP header, HTTP header, HTTP data, as well as the physical trailer for end-to-end connectivity over the network. Now, if you look into the context of transport layer, that why we require the transport layer here. Now, just below the transport layer, you have the network layer and the functionality of the network layer to ensure datagram delivery here. So when we say datagram delivery, is indicates that network layer, whenever it will receive the packet, in the packet or in a network layer context, we call it as a datagram. So whenever it will receive the datagram, in the datagram, there is a source address and a destination field. So the task of network layer is to look into the destination address and accordingly forward this packet to the next hop here. So the network layer basically ensures that data delivery among the multiple hops in your devices. Say example, say if you want to transfer datagram to transfer certain application, certain data from one machine to the other machine and going to access via some world wide web access here or .com. So whenever you're going to access that data, data need to be transferred from one machine to the other machine here. The Google server which is there in another port will transfer the data. Now in the between this there are multiple routers which are there, will be, we can call it as a layer 3 switch, or sometimes you can call it as a switch. Some people will call it as a layer 3 switch, some people they call it as a router. So there are multiple routers, there is in between the, so the task of this routers is to forward the packet to the end system here, end host. Now whenever the routers are forwarding the packet to end system or end host, we are thinking about the packet switching principle or packet switching architecture. In the principle of packet switching architecture or packet switching multiplexing, what happens that intermediate routers have finite amount of buffer and architecture. What happens that the intermediate routers have the finite amount of buffer and as well as the packets may push at that buffer here. Then the router performs a route lookup by looking into the header of the packet and decide that which packet outgoing interface the packet need to be transferred here. Now when the router is doing this task, by the time it is receiving multiple data from multiple other neighboring routers here. So the architecture of this entire network is really little complicated. So let me just give you one example. So if you have one intermediate router here who's tasked to send data and it also receiving data from multiple routers here. The task is to send the data and also receiving the data from multiple other routers here. So if it is sending the data from all the different routers, then task is to send this data to some next router or to multiple next hop routers here. This data to some next hop router or to multiple next hop routers. Now this particular router, it maintains an interface queue. Example say queue will temporarily hold all the packets. Now it can, in any device, this type of particular host, a particular device has a finite amount of buffer space within it. Because it has finite amount of buffer space, it may happen that a high load in a network or a buffer become a full. When the buffer will become a full, the packets start dropping from the intermediate routers here. So that way, network layer, all the tasks to find out, the way the network layer will task to find out or task to send the data packets from one host to another end host. Many of times it fails to support reliability in the sense that there is no guarantee that data will be delivered or transferred from end to end host or end to end systems here. It may happen that intermediate routers, that packet may be dropped because of this kind of buffer overflow, or apart from the buffer overflow, there can be error in during the physical transmission of packet. There can be a channel interference which can be happen in the case of the wireless network here. So there are multiple reasons because of this packet may be dropped. Now whenever the packet getting dropped, the packet is being lost during the end-to-end delivery of a packet by the network layer. So we can say that network layer to end-to-end delivery of a packet by the network layer. So we can say that network layer provides a datagram delivery, but this datagram delivery is unreliable. So it supports unreliable datagram delivery here. Now, however, you are providing unreliable datagram delivery at the network layer, then transport layer, you task to ensure that packets and message which are you are trying to send from one host to other host, the messages are transferred correctly. So in other words, we can say that application should not be hampered by a loss of data from the intermediate routers or intermediate network devices, you can say. So the transport layer, it take care of the particular thing and provides reliable data delivery on top of the unreliable data gram delivery which is supported by the network layer. So coming classes we'll discuss more services of the transport layer. Thank you for listening this session. Thank you.